Hi, I'm Blaine Bartel. Welcome to another edition of Fire by Night. It's great to have you with us on the program. We have with us one of the top Christian contemporary music groups today, DeGarmo and Key. They're going to be sharing their thoughts on the second coming of Jesus. And that's what we're talking about on the program this month. We're talking about facing the future, how you can be ready for what God has for you in your life. Did you know that Jesus is coming back very soon? He's right on the verge of coming back to take away his church. And we're going to tell you in this program how you can be ready.
Welcome to So You Think You Can Write a Book, the book review program with your host, Lewis P. Emmingworth.
Hello, bookworms. As you know, last week we reviewed the book Charlotte's Web. What a ridiculous book. How many of you make spiders your close friends? And we also took a look at Treasure Island. Absolutely a ridiculous joke. I can't believe the guy bothered to write the thing myself. This week we have a very special guest with us. His name is Dr. Hal Lindsey. He is the author of a book known as The Late Great Planet Earth. It is a bestseller in the religious market. Dr. Lindsey, it's good to have you here today.
It's good to be here.
Dr. Lindsey, in just taking a quick glance at your book, I noticed something about it that you seem to be a man who's heavily into science fiction and fantasy. For instance, you have a part in it where you say that Jesus is going to come back to Earth and take all of his followers away with him in what you call the rapture. Oh, gosh. I mean, I know where he got this from, guys. Check it out. Scotty, beat me up. Captain, I would if I could have, but I kinda so I won't. Our dilithium crystals just won't take the strain. Do you really expect us to believe that?
Yes, I do.
Oh, come on now, Mr. Lindsey. Besides Star Trek novels, where do you get this preposterous information?
If you have your Bibles, turn with me to the book of 1 Thessalonians, chapter 4. Verses 16 and 17. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord.
And the scarecrow gets a brain, and the tin man gets a heart, and Toto gets a shampoo, but Mr. Lindsey, what I want to know is this. As mayor of the Munchkin City, in the city and the land of Oz, I'd like to ask you a question most gleefully. Where do we Munchkins fit into your story? So come on, Hal, baby, tell me, when are we going on this star cruise anyway?
Me? Not all of us are going, Lewis. You must confess Jesus Christ as your Lord and be saved.
Oh, excuse me. You've got rules for this little contest of yours, eh? Yes, ladies and gentlemen, you must be 18 years of age. Your hair must be cut above your ears. And above all, you must be wearing a polyester suit. Get out of here, Hal, baby. Whoa. How did he do that? Neat trick, yes. Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us this week. Next week, we're going to have the political author, Damien, discussing his new book, One World Government, The Mark of Success. thank you for joining us this week on So You Think You Can Write a Book. And remember, getting me back for the exploding cigars, huh, fellas?
Accommodations for guests on this program, when they don't disappear, are provided by the Mark Hotels in exchange for this announcement. Are you afraid that this would happen to you? Or should we say to your vehicle when you get raptured? Your car flying uncontrollably into innocent people. Well, when you get sent to heaven, don't send someone else to hell. We have just what you need. The Acme brand parking device, guaranteed to park your car upon the actual taking away of the driver. The Acme brand parking device will not affect everyday operation of your vehicle. Only upon rapture will it automatically slow your car down, pull it to the side of the road, flip on the hazard lights, put it in park, shut the motor off, and lock your car in case of illegal entry. And it's so easy to install. Even a two-year-old could do it in less than an hour. The Acme brand parking device. Affordable, easy, and efficient. So for your peace of mind at that golden moment, send $10.95 to Acme brand parking device, care of the Gabriel Corporation, Post Office Box 12. That's all the address you'll need. Order before midnight tonight, because this offer could end within a twinkling of an eye.
I've been told through the grapevine that you guys are childhood friends. Is this rumor true?
We're childish friends.
We've never been friends, actually. Okay. We've just known each other for a lot of years.
We met, actually, in the first grade, and he and I have, well, we've discovered that we live very close together out in Whitehaven in Memphis, Tennessee, and grew up down the street from Elvis Presley's house and have been playing music ever since.
So when exactly did DeGarmo and Key start out as a band?
Well, we started playing bands in the sixth grade. Right. Yeah, all the way back. We had Beetle Boots and Love Boots. Lost many a talent contest to them. And senior year in high school is when we became Christians.
We didn't officially become DeGarmo and Key until 1977, when we decided, well, we didn't actually decide, we accepted the invitation that Pat Boone gave us to record a record for his recording label.
Have a video 666. It was originally rejected by MTV. Why don't you just share a little bit about that video and set it up for us?
Okay. Well, basically, 666 is a song about the development of this character in the Bible that we see called the Antichrist. And DeGarmo Key has often talked about the return of Jesus, but we know that the Bible speaks of more than just the return of Jesus. It sets the stage for the return of Christ with this guy called the Antichrist. And in the song 666 in the video, what we're trying to do is kind of give an impression of what it might be like if you ran into the Antichrist before he became a world politician and a world figure. And the whole intention of the video and the song is just to spur people's thinking about end times, and so they can adjust their lives accordingly.
Jesus, won't you save me from this evil man of sin? night when I thought was just a dream. And I went to call my neighbor and to tell him all I'd seen. And when I reached for my address book, I felt sick.
You know that the destiny of our world is not in the hands of some mad military leader who pushes some nuclear button. The destiny of the world is in the hands of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. In fact, the Bible, if you read it, 1 in 7 scriptures talks about history or future events. It's very clear on what's going to happen. In fact, I have a scripture here I'd like to share with you. It's found in 1 Thessalonians 4, verses 16 and 17. It says, "For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, so shall we ever be with the Lord." That is talking about the catching away of the church, the rapture. Jesus is coming back for his church. He wants us to be ready for that. Now, there's a parable that tells us how to be ready in Matthew 25. It talks about 10 virgins. 5 were foolish and 5 were wise. 5 had oil in their lamps and were ready for the bridegroom to come, and 5 did not have oil and were not ready. The 5 that had oil were the ones that had salvation, the ones that knew Jesus. The 5 that were foolish did not know him, were not ready. And you know, the rapture is just like getting ready to be married. When you get ready to be married, man, you do your best to look your best. You get a nice tuxedo. You send out invitations to all your friends because you want everyone to be there. And that's the way it is with Jesus and his coming. We want to be ready for him. We want to be our best. We want to be a church without spot or wrinkle, and we want to invite other people, friends, to come with us and make them ready too. So you make sure you're ready, and you make sure you're making others ready for the rapture of the church.
Better feed that dog and get that pan cleaned.
Mom? Dad?
I'm home. Where is she? Dad? 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 Dad, are you in here? Dad? Dad, are you in there? Oh, no, it can't.
can't be. It can't be. Oh, God, I missed the rapture. Oh, God, please forgive me for taking the car last night without asking for permission. And forgive me for threatening to beat up my little brother Mike if he wouldn't take the trash out for me. Oh, Lord, please.
Please. Mike, are you all right, son?
Dad, I'm... Oh, gee, it's good to see you guys. I'm just practicing lines for a school play. Yeah.
Son, I think we need to have a little talk. The car, huh?
Now, wouldn't it just be easier to know that you're ready?
In today's fast-paced world, it pays to stay ahead of the competition, to know where you're going tomorrow, and most importantly, to be ready. That's why I and millions of others read Prophetic News Today.
That's right. We've covered the latest on what's happening with the Soviet Union and their march from the north against Israel.
I read it every day.
And the Ruskies are on their way.
We told you about earthquakes in the most diverse places, from Mexico to Europe and everywhere in between. And that's not all. Prophetic News Today has extensive coverage on moral decline in our world.
I read it every day. And you know, half my neighborhood's gay.
We know about wars, such as in Nicaragua and many other hot spots in the world today. We'll keep you informed on the constant threat to our religious freedoms.
I read it every day, but my school won't let me pray. But I do it anyway.
But the most exciting part of our report is on the revival of God's Spirit that's sweeping the world in these last days.
Well, are you convinced? Millions just like you are discovering the truth each year. Isn't it about time that you kept up with the times? Prophetic News Today. You better subscribe now. Today could be the last issue.
We read it every day. Prophetic News Today.
Prophetic News Today. Available now at bookstores, coffee tables, and fine hotel rooms everywhere.
How close do you feel we are to the coming of the Lord?
Well, beginning with the birth, or the rebirth, I should say, of the nation of Israel, we're beginning to see a lot of the biblical prophecies come to pass in our lifetime. And we're seeing the stage set for more prophecies to come to pass that couldn't have been fulfilled until modern times. So we believe that this generation has a real possibility of seeing Jesus Christ split those skies and come back. And perhaps if not this generation, the next. But it doesn't really matter if Jesus comes back in this generation or the next. What really matters is that we live our lives each day as if Jesus were going to come back that day. That's what's really important.
People today in secular high schools who don't know Jesus, and their attitude is, well, what's there to live for? I mean, someone could push the button any day and we could have nuclear war. There's no future. What would you tell a young person like that, Dana?
Well, you know, in high school, most people are trying to point a kid to the future, and that's important to look down the road 20 years and see what your career is going to be. But what I would tell a kid in high school is don't throw your high school years away looking too much to the future. Live your life every day to the fullest. And when I say live your life to the fullest, my life didn't become full until I found Jesus Christ. You know, I was going 20 miles an hour until I gave my life to Christ, and he sped my life up to 90 miles an hour. And, you know, most kids would think that trusting Christ is just the reverse, that you slow down and you become conservative and go to church. But the Lord put a lot of meaning in my life. You know, he answered questions, basic questions about where I came from, why I was here, where I'm going. He gave me a mission and a purpose every day. So I have a reason to live my life every day as if Jesus were coming back.
Ed, how would you sum up the message that DeGarmo and Key has for Christian young people?
We feel like that that Christianity, even though it's becoming very popular today, and it seems almost in vogue, you know, to say that you're a Christian. Everybody thinks that's cool. But we feel like that it's our place to tell kids that Christianity is a very practical lifestyle, even in America in the 1980s. And Jesus can walk with you through every area of your life, not just what happens on Sunday morning, but when you go to high school on Monday, you know, when you go to work in the afternoon, when you have problems with your parents, because He is Lord over our whole life. And we try to tell kids that there is but one life to live. You know, there's not church and then there's not this. There's one life. And that's really the only way that you can find peace in your life.
What's Hot? I'm Ron Luce, here to make sure you're up on the Christian music scene. Some people go to Christian concerts to hear their favorite artist. Others go to get entertained. But there are a certain breed who go in hopes that in the midst of all the music and fanfare, they could really hear God. If you're this type, you need to check out Steve Camp the next time he comes to your area. In his latest album, One on One, Camp tries to demonstrate his conscientiousness in really hearing God and sharing what he hears with those who care to really listen. Youth Choir, now known as The Choir, have just released their third album, and it's more commercial and pop-sounding than the others. This is their first album on a major label, and it attempts to depict the heart of God to a rockin' beat with lyrics like, I painted mercy, show me your pain, I painted diamonds, don't fear the rain. Now it's time for our Fire by Night Top 10 Countdown. Says that in the last days, Antichrist will arise and deceive many. It seems that the spirit of the Antichrist is so prevalent in today's secular rock music. We don't have to search for hidden words and backmasking to hear the devil's influence in today's pop sounds. We've got people paying to hear groups like Black Sabbath, Christian Death, Lords of Sin, Coven, which is a name for a group of witches, Lords of the New Church, Slayer, with their album titled Hell Awaits, Venom, who titled an album Welcome to Hell, and Demon, who titled an album Possessed. These groups and many more are singing overtly demonic lyrics like Motley Crue, who cry, Come now, children of the beast, be strong. Now, they'll say that they're doing it for the money, but the Bible warns us about those who are money-hungry in the end times, because that's the root of all evil anyway. The fact is that you never hear these secular rock groups denounce Buddha or Muhammad. They're only against Jesus or Antichrist. So don't you be deceived by their demon-praising, money-making tactics, but rather, as Timothy commanded, have nothing to do with them. Well, I'm Ron Luce, and that's What's Hot. We'll see you next month.
Dad, if you keep yelling that loud, you're going to hurt my ears.
Your mother wants you to help her wash the dishes, please.
Oh, okay. I got an idea. Connie, why don't you clear the dishes off the counter?
Yeah.
And then put them in the dishwasher.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And what are you going to do?
Well, I'll add the soap. I mean, someone's got to do it. It's a dirty job, but I'll do it, right, Dad?
Are we expecting someone tonight?
I don't think so.
My eardrums are taking a beating tonight.
Hey, Carlos, Beaver Bazinski, two doors down, just moved in.
Oh, you're the gentleman that's building the swimming pool in your backyard.
Swimming pool, nothing. I hate swimming pools. That's a bomb shelter for my family's security and possibly yours, too. Hey, here's some information. Read it. Acne bomb shelters.
Well, what's this for?
What's it for? Come on, where you been the past 20 years? Don't you know the commies are going to blow us all up? They want to annihilate us. They want you to glow in the dark. Collins, they want your kids to look like a bunch of mutant raisin heads. Oh, my God! Get out, Collins! This could be the big one!
My son is learning to play the trumpet. Is this some kind of gimmick to get me to buy some life insurance?
Life insurance? Listen, Collins, the only insurance you need is to sign this puppy right here.
Well, what for?
What for? Collins, do you pay taxes? This is to get the city of Chicago to pay for our own community bomb shelter.
Well, I don't think we're interested, but I'll think about...
I guess the battery's getting a little weak. Doesn't sound as loud as it used to be. I'll tell you what, Collins. I got a family bomb shelter drill in 5 minutes, but you think about it. You hear me? You think about it. Now!
Tonight we're going to start talking about an exciting new series, and that is the second coming of Jesus Christ. And I want you to turn to Matthew chapter 24, and we'll look at some scriptures very quickly, beginning in Matthew 24, that will give you some details and some scripture references as to what the rapture or the second coming is all about. No man knows the hour or the day that Jesus is going to return. So let's look at 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 17. It's going to tell us something about that. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 17, and it reads this way, "Then we which are alive and remain," that means those of us who are born again, "shall be caught up together with them in the clouds," or the other believers, "to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord." From now on, we're going to be with the Lord. So what we need to understand is Jesus could return this year, next month, next week, tomorrow, or he could even come tonight.
Awesome!
What we need to understand as believers is what we can do to make ourselves ready. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time together.
Was that not the most awesome message you've ever heard in your entire life?
That was great.
I mean, do you actually realize how soon Jesus could be returning? It could all be over in one of these.
An eyelash?
No. The twinkling of an eye. I wonder who the Antichrist is. I've got it. It's Pee-wee Herman. He's got a real big following. And that whole nice guy routine, I bet it's just a front.
The Antichrist is not Pee-wee Herman. I mean, the Bible doesn't say anywhere that the Antichrist is a nerd.
Well, at least that rules me out. Wait a minute. I've got it. Why didn't I think of this before?
What?
Why didn't I think of this before?
What?
Our math class, room number 666, Mr. Schnickelgroover.
Mr. Schnickelgroover?
He's the Antichrist. Oh, he's so obvious. How did I miss it? Wait a minute. I've got to go drop my math class before it's too late.
School's not open. It's 9 o'clock at night.
O'Driscoll, eat your heart out. Robert! Would you quit it? Look what you made me do. Look at my face.
Please don't subject me to that kind of torture.
Why don't you go find Mom and tell her that she wants you?
Help!
Mother!
Hey, listen to this. They just passed this new law. When people from Illinois go into the state of Texas, if they'll put their high school diploma on the dashboard of their car, they can park in the handicap parking zone.
Well, that's great. Since we're from Illinois now, when we go back home, we can get all the best parking places.
Yeah. No, honey, you don't understand. You see, never mind. Maybe I'll tell Connie. Nah. Where have I heard this name before?
Who's that?
Buford Belinsky. Oh, wait a minute. That's the guy that was over here last night trying to get us to sign that petition. Look it. He and a bunch of other crazies are picketing City Hall.
About their bomb shelter?
Yeah, that guy is totally obsessed with nuclear war stuff. Man.
You know what that is, don't you? That's the spirit of fear in this world. Well, people are putting 20 locks on every door. There's international terrorism. Little kids are getting kidnapped all the time. Then they come out with these awful movies like Halloween 10 and Texas Chainsaw Massacre number 13. Not to mention there's nuclear missiles aimed at everybody and their dog.
Just be glad we don't have a dog. No, honey, I'm just kidding. Hey, you know, you're right. I mean, everybody is scared out of their slippers these days.
Well, they don't have to be.
Well, I'll tell you what. If I didn't know Jesus, I'd be just as afraid as old Buford Belinsky.
Yeah, you're right. What have they got to put their hope in?
Yeah. You know, honey, old Buford's a strange type fella. But what would you think if you and I went over to his house and witnessed to him about Jesus?
Come on in, Clarence.
Doug, you'll never guess what I just figured out.
Try me.
I just figured out the exact moment in time of Jesus' return.
You're kidding.
No, next Thursday at 1600 hours and 15 minutes.
1600 hours from today?
No, next Thursday at 4:15.
How'd you figure this out?
Well, through the mathematical processes of geology, zoology, trigonometry, skyology, and untold volumes of Bible doctrines, and 3 2-liter bottles of Pepsi Free.
That is ridiculous. No one knows when Jesus is coming back, especially you.
Oh, well, that's where you're wrong. I mean, God's giving new revelation. Okay, check this out. Doesn't it say in the Bible that he's coming back for those who are ready?
Yeah.
Well, that means that if you're not ready, you won't go. Have you ever not been ready for a test? Have you ever not been ready for a game? Have you ever not been ready for the migration season of the East African wildebeest? I mean, what we need to do is we need to organize. We'll form a Get Ready for the Rapture Club, GRF-TRC. I'll be president, and you can be vice president.
I don't know.
That's okay. We'll get somebody else. We'll get buttons and brochures and T-shirts. And we'll advertise in Honeycomb Magazine, and DeGarmo and Key will be my national spokesman. Okay, picture this.
We will boldly go where no man has gone before.
Well, I sprained my ankle crawling through the trench the guy's got all around his front lawn.
Hey! What are you doing here? Collins, this is restricted area. Put these helmets on, quick! There you go. Now, welcome to my little world. Hey, Collins, check this out. Just made it. Noogies for news. Glad you guys finally came to your senses. Welcome aboard.
Yeah. Listen, Belinsky, Cheryl, my wife, and I came over to talk...
I know what you came over here for. You came over here to invest in another fine acne bomb shelter. I'll tell you what, Collins, $200 down, I can get you into a perfect bomb shelter. A little weak in the ceiling, but well worth the price. Because you never know when old garbage head's going to push the big red button over there in Tommy Land.
Yeah. No, actually, we came over here to talk to you about something.
Oh, I know what you came over here for. You want to be in the march this Saturday, and you came by to pick up your picket sign. Hold it right there.
No.
Collins, check this out. Knock on a nuke. Perfect, huh? How about this one? Stop Star Wars 2. My favorite one, Collins. Have you shot a commie today? I tell you what, it's a good thing you got here early. Those really go fast.
Belinsky. At ease! Belinsky, listen. We came over here to talk to you about something.
Well, why didn't you say so? Speak up!
You don't have to worry about being annihilated, Belinsky.
Miss Collins, is your husband a commie or something? Niet nukies?
Mr. Buford.
That's Belinsky!
Okay, Belinsky, if you'd just be quiet for a minute, we'd like to talk to you about something.
I'm all ears.
Listen, the Bible agrees with you that there will be war.
What?
And famines and pestilences.
Yeah, but it says that you can escape all those things.
Escape? What do you think I built this bomb shelter for? I got enough rations in here to last me 6 months.
Okay, that's good. But what are you going to do after 6 months? Have you thought about that?
Yeah, I have. Then I'm going to... No, I haven't thought about that.
Listen, it's an honorable thing that you want to preserve life after nuclear war. But what about your life right now?
Yeah, and more than that, what about your eternal life?
Eternal life?
Sit down over here, Belinsky. We want to talk to you about something.
Eternal life?
I want to tell you about something special, Belinsky. We want to talk to you about Jesus.
I think Clarence has gone a little bit overboard with this whole rapture thing. I mean, he has run up his dad's credit cards to the hilt. He keeps saying, well, who's going to pay for it anyways if we're all gone?
I know. I tried to talk to him, but he just won't listen. We have a term paper. It's due tomorrow. He hasn't even started on it.
Yeah, well, then again, his tomorrow's off in the wild blue yonder.
Well, I'm going to go practice my trumpet. What time are they coming over?
Well, it should be any minute or he'll miss his glory call.
Well, looks like the show's about to begin.
Come on in, Clarence.
Rapture Club, unite!
Doug, I'm sorry you're not as ready as we are. Just stand by. Okay, everybody, assume rapture positions. Start rapture breathing now. In 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, the dead are going now. Oh, God sure must have big eyes. That's a long twinkling. Stand by, here we go. Okay, start jumping. Start rapture jumping.
You moron, we're still here.
Yeah.
I was afraid of this, comrades, but there's sin in the camp. No, we all missed it. Okay, go on home, and I'll call you in 7 years, and if anybody tries to put anything on your forehead, don't let them. Doug, Connie, you guys missed it too? Mr. and Mrs. C, you guys too?
Clarence, come over here. We've got to talk.
You bet we do. We've got a lot of planning if we're going to get through this tribulation together.
Clarence, there was no rapture today. The Bible says no man knows the time or the day but the Father in heaven.
But I heard the trumpet.
Gee, 3 weeks and I already sound like Gabriel.
So it didn't happen. But we still got to be ready.
Well, sure we've got to be ready. But we don't get ready by having some rapture practice.
We need to be like Jesus. We need to be about our Father's business.
Yeah, you've been acting like our neighbor, Buford Belinsky. All he's been thinking about is tomorrow's nuclear wars. He hasn't even been living for today. Besides, the Bible says we're supposed to occupy till he comes.
And Clarence, that means telling other people about Jesus so they can be ready for tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Tomorrow? I've got a term paper, my dad's credit cards.
And Syrian forces are all reportedly building up along the southern Lebanese border, threatening to invade Israel. Warnings from the United States and allies.
The world around us in a rage.
Have also been ignored.
Newspapers tell of fear on every page. The prophecies of old unravel and unfold. In time's last days, in of the age, Satan strikes with deceitful power, seeking and searching whom he may devour. The prophets do arise, the signs are in the skies, the sands run down, earth. Such a time as this, such a time as this, this is it. God placed his special gifts in you. Believer, fight for what you know is true. Today, cast down and company lies. Courageously stand up for the truth. Cause you have come into the kingdom. For such a time as this, to fulfill, you see, the destiny for your life. Such a time as this, such a time as this, this is it. You have come into the kingdom for such a time as this.
know, in Matthew 24, verse 3, the disciples came to Jesus and they said, Jesus, we want to know when you're coming. Give us some signs of when you will return. And I believe all of us should know these signs. Jesus went on to list a number of signs that would transpire before he came back. These are things that will help you to see that Jesus' return is imminent. It's upon us. It could be any day, any minute, any hour. The first thing that he said would happen would there would be a great deception in the earth, that there would arise false teachers and cults and people that had false doctrines teaching that Jesus was not Lord, that other people were Lord, other people were to be served as God. And this has happened. We've had the rise in so many cults from the Eastern religions. And, you know, I was thinking a while back when I was a youth leader, I had a guy walk into my office, and he came in there, and he said, hey, I've come to proclaim something. And I said, well, what is it? He said, I've come to tell you that I am Jesus. And I looked at this guy, and he didn't look like Jesus. I mean, he had... There was, and not only did he not look like Jesus, he didn't act like Jesus. He picked up this magazine of a prominent evangelist and said, this guy doesn't know anything. He needs to come to me. I've got all the truth. And Jesus prophesied himself. He said, in the last days, there would be people who would claim to be Christ, but are false Christ and antichrist. So that's one thing that he said would happen. Another thing he said would happen, he said there'd be great famines. Now, he said this 2,000 years ago. He said, in the last days, there would be famines. And we've seen it. There's famines everywhere in the world today. Hundreds of people die every day in planet Earth because they don't have enough food. Famine has swept across the land in our last days. And then another thing he said was pestilences. Now, some of you may think a pestilence is an insect or something like that. And actually, the Webster's Dictionary defines it as such. But another definition of a pestilence is a sickness, actually an epidemic, fatal disease. And that's what the Bible was speaking of in this case. It was talking about epidemic diseases that would take over the land in the last few days before Jesus came back. And we've seen that. In the last years, we've seen things like cancer that has just ripped people apart and taken their lives at an early age. We've seen more recently AIDS come in and destroy just hundreds of young people that, you know, especially the homosexual group. And in fact, I read the other day some facts on AIDS. It says no individual diagnosed as having AIDS before 1981 is alive today. That's unbelievable. And then it says the average life expectancy of an AIDS patient is, after the diagnosis, is only 18 months. Epidemic, fatal diseases, and Jesus prophesied these things would happen. Another thing Jesus said, there would be wars and rumors of wars. Now, I don't need to tell you that we have wars in the earth today. You can pick up any newspaper, look at any newscast on television, and they're going to tell you there's wars going on all over the earth. Military buildup. And that is a sign, Jesus said, of his coming. And then another one that is very interesting is earthquakes. Jesus said there would be a lot of earthquakes just before he came back. Some of you may say, well, there's always been earthquakes. I mean, they've been with us forever. But listen to this. In the 16th century, there were 115. In the 17th century, there were 253 earthquakes. In the 18th century, 378. In the 19th century, 640. Now get this. In the 20th century, there have been 2,119 earthquakes. They've increased dramatically in our century. And that's a sign that Jesus is approaching and coming very, very soon. The last thing, and I believe the most important thing, is the outpouring of the Spirit in the last days. Acts chapter 2 talks about it. Jesus said, before I come back, I'm going to pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. Sons and daughters will prophesy. Young men will see visions. Old men will dream dreams. God is pouring out his Spirit upon all flesh. And it's interesting, the first group that he said he'd poured out upon was the young people. You know, I believe that, you know, there's all kinds of negative things that are happening, but I believe the greatest thing is that Jesus is giving everyone on earth another chance. I believe he's delaying his coming. In fact, the Word tells us that he has delayed his coming so that he can give everyone that could possibly hear a chance to receive the gospel. And God wants you to have a chance. Some of you aren't ready for Jesus to come back. If you were to come right now, you wouldn't be ready. Some of you are ready, but you're not making other people ready, and you need to. There's a man in the Bible. I want to close with this. There's a man in the Bible. His name was Samson. And Samson is just like the church. He judged Israel for 20 years, just like the church has been on the earth for 2,000 years. And Samson saw more happen in the last few hours of his life than he had in the entire life previous. He saw more Philistines killed as he broke those pillars down than he had in the years before, all put together in his life. And that's just like the church. The church in the last days is going to see more souls come into the kingdom, more people one to Jesus than they've ever seen in the history of the church. And get this, the person that led Samson into the pillars, into the place that caused him to have that great victory, was a young man. God wants to use you, young person. He wants to use you to be a revolution of His love in this last day, reaching out to the lost. I want to pray for you. God wants to touch your life. I want you to give Jesus a chance in your life. Some of you have never done that. You're here, you're watching the program, and you've never given Jesus a chance to take over in your life. You need to be ready for Him. Don't miss the rapture. Don't miss His coming. Let me pray for you right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray with all the compassion in my heart for those teenagers that are watching, for parents that are watching, that they would be ready for Your coming in Jesus' name. I ask You to convict them of their sins and let them receive Your forgiveness, washing them white as snow and preparing them for Your coming, Lord. And we give You praise for it and thanksgiving for it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Like a thief in the night, just like lightning in the sky, when Jesus comes to take His church away, yeah, where the wave of His hand will be in the promised land, and the people of the Lord will sing His praise. Alleluia, Christ is coming with His angels at His side. Alleluia, Christ is coming, coming for His bride. Days are dark, hearts are cold, yet there's reason still to hope when we rest upon the promises He made.
You don't want to miss us next month. Milon Lefebvre, we're going to be talking about the truth about rock and roll music. We want to thank DeGarmo and Key this month for being with us. And right now, we're going to choose our winner for the Youth Express Winter Weekend coming up here in just a few days. And right now, we're going to take a look at who is the winner. Carl Fajam from Presque Isle, Maine. And he says, "Dear Blaine, I'm 13 and I would like to be on Fire by Night because it's a good Christian video. I would also like to be on Muskogee Vice because my sister and I have our own comedy group and it would be good practice for us." Well, Carl, you are going to get a lot of practice at Winter Park, Colorado, coming up real soon here. We're glad to have you with us. Congratulations. Until next month, God bless you guys.